going to talk about how to do an I. Okay, so there are a couple things to think about. There's a couple ways to start. Some people I know start their eyes by starting by drawing the whole eyeball and then putting the lid around it and then filling in the other parts, which is totally fine. If this is the way you do it, that's great. That's gonna definitely give you that shape that you're looking for. Some people just start by making just the shape, and that's fine. If you're looking at a picture or looking at somebody's eye, you're going to wanna make your shape match up with their eye shape for observational drawing. So if you're making just the shape, think of like a football or an almond or a lemon shape. Those are some shapes you can think about when you're thinking about doing these. So then you would have your eyelid that would come above that. And kind of way above that would be your eyebrow. Kind of up that far. So I'm starting up here just to get used to shading. I always start with the secondary things like the eyelid. So the eyelid up here is gonna have a nice little shadow right along the lash line. Also where the eyelid creases, you're gonna have a nice little shadow that kind of comes down because your eyelid is kind of roundish. And that gives the illusion of it going back into and folding under right there. The top of your eyelid. This is really good practice for doing very, very light shading. There's where the crease is. Oftentimes, right up here, there's a little bit of a shadow as well. Where it's folding. As you go up towards the eyebrow, there tends to be a little bit of shading up there as well. This then would be like the edge of the nose. That's just because your eyebrow protrudes out a little bit there, and that's to protect things from getting in your eye. That's why you have an eyebrow. Think about when you're washing your hair. It keeps the soap from getting into your eye, dripping down. Everything on your face has a purpose. Okay, so as we get over here, usually up here, there's like that part of your brow bone sticks out a little bit. So there's a little bit of a highlight up there. So it tends to get lighter. On this side, it tends to be darker. The edge here of your eye lid is also going to be more in shadow. Just doing all my mid-tones. We'll get the darks at the very end. And kind of fade out. Now we're ready to start working on the eye. So when you're drawing, the colored part of your eye needs to be round, but it's going to be taken up by some of your eyelid. Drawing your eye this way will ensure of that, because once I erase that out, you would see that it is taken up by some of your eyelid. You also have a round spot in the middle, okay? I also like to go ahead and draw some highlights just so that I kind of get the sense that I'm drawing an eye. I'm gonna start with this colored part here. So I'm gonna draw my mid-tone. Now, some of your mid-tones might be darker than other mid-tones, and that is because if you're drawing someone with really light crystal blue eyes or really light green eyes, you're going to see that their eyes are actually, when you're doing them in gray, would be much lighter. Some of us have very dark eyes. I've got very dark green, or for some people have very dark brown, and then it's gonna be much harder to see a lot of the shadows in those eyes. But you will also notice still that you might start with a darker mid-tone, which means your darker darks are gonna have to be even darker than that. So now that I have my mid-tone in here, something that you need to think about is that your eyelid casts a shadow onto your eye. So I am now shading where the cast shadow would be. This is my darker tone shading into my mid-tone. Same thing over here. Shading down. Something else to think about is most eyes, when you look at the very edge of them, the color, it's a little darker around the edge than it is in the center. And it's not always the case, but it is oftentimes. So I typically do a little darker around the edge. Now, we need to move on to the inside, the black part. So when you're doing that part of your eye, you're gonna be using a lot of pressure. Okay, just like that. Now, up here would still be darker, so if you can press even harder just to get that little shadow at the top. And since you're also making that part shadow at the top, this little highlight that you're gonna leave white will have a very light shadow on it as well. Okay? This white part of your eye will also have a very light shadow, so barely touching, because your eyelid is casting a shadow onto your eyeball. Same thing over here. Sometimes it even comes down a little bit like that. Very light shading. Okay, here you will have that little area in the corner of your eye. Some of that should be kind of left white because it's wet. You have what they call your waterline. And then underneath your waterline, there is a cast shadow from your eyeball, because your eyeball is actually round and protrudes out a little bit. And then, so there is a cast shadow of your eyeball, and your eyelashes also make a little cast shadow down here. And eyelashes are the very last thing that we do. Right in here sometimes tends to be a little darker. Kind of where the nose is. Usually right around here, this is lighter, right outside of that little pink thing. So now I'm checking out my eye and I see areas that I need to come back in and darken right along the lash line. Be a little darker. If you lose your waterline, you can always take the edge of your pencil eraser and erase it back out. And there we go. Right in here, I feel like should be just a little bit darker. Okay, so let's talk a little quickly here about a couple of things. Let's talk about eyebrows. When you're doing eyebrows, you draw the eyebrows in the direction that they grow. So that's a basic shape. So your hair on your eyebrow. So look at someone's eyebrow if you need to. They grow up and then they tend to curve this way as you go through the arch. So whenever you're drawing hair of any kind, fur on an animal, hair on a human, you're going to want to draw it in the direction that it grows, each and every hair. So I'm going to start here with the eyebrow. And the hairs are longer towards the middle. And then as you go around the arch of the eyebrow, they tend to get smaller. And they tend to curve. Okay, so there's the eyebrow. Let's talk now about the eyelashes. So the lashes are going to be coming out of here. So I'm going to use this one as my first example. When you're making your eyelashes, they're going to be very quick marks like that, very quick. So you're pressing down and then pulling up as you're going out. You might want to just practice making some marks like that. Now, when you're doing them on the side here, they are going to go this direction on the side. As you get more towards the middle, they lean in and end up pointing up. As you get more towards the corner of your eye on this side, they go that direction. They are thicker on the outside and thinner on the inside. Same thing as the bottom. If you don't believe me, look at anybody's eyeballs. You'll see exactly how the eyelashes grow. They're the very last thing you do, so make sure you're happy with all of your shading first. Then, like, I think we need a little bit more shading here, and then I'll be happy with it. Okay, so I'm gonna start with my eyelashes, like I said there, the very last thing you do straight up towards the middle, curve around this direction. Make them thicker on the outside from the lash line. A good thing to practice these because you can't really erase them without erasing all the work you've already done. Same thing on the bottom, point that direction. As you get to the middle, they're going to point down, and as you get towards the other corner, they're going to point that direction. Your lashes on the bottom are not nearly as thick as your lashes on the top. Lashes have a purpose. They are to protect things from getting into your eyeball. There we go. So I've got some nice lashes on mine. Other things, so for some advanced students that might want to be thinking about doing like the little shades and stuff that are in each like little flecks in your eyeball, you are welcome to then go ahead and add those. I would add those before you do your eyelashes in case you don't like them and you want to erase them out and everything. But you are welcome to come back in, and if you're observing a photo of an eyeball that has those kinds of little flecks and things in them, you are totally welcome to come in and add those in there. It just changes the way that they look, makes it look a little bit more realistic. But that's up to you, because not everybody has those. So something like that, I don't know, it's up to you. I just feel like this needs to be a little darker. There we go, nice eyeball. You will be using a couple of different visual references for looking at eyes. I have some papers here that you can choose from. You can also look at the person who's sitting across from you. Look at their eyes so that you can see how to draw eyes the correct way. And drawing from observation is always the best when you're talking about realistic things when you're learning.